love can't reach. There's no place where we can't find peace. There's no end to amazing grace. Take me in with your arms spread wide. Take me in like an orphan child. Never let go, never leave my side.
Welcome to a special episode of TLE TV. I'm your host, NH Labduni. And today, in this episode, what I want to do is reach out to our black family. A friend of mine on Twitter hit me up and sent me this message about our nieces and nephews, brothers and sisters, cousins, not being able to attend school in Haiti because promises of donations have not come through. Now mind you, it's not a large organization, it's not those big corporate organizations that are funneling all the donation money to take care of their overhead while 2% actually goes towards some of the Haitian people. This organization has been doing something for the children of Haiti for a long time. And the name of the organization is Love Haiti's Children. Now, when I received this message from Vicky, she goes by Lady Worship on Twitter, LadyWorship. Her handle name, Love Haiti's Children. And she sent me a picture of six, 12 kids, boys and girls, who are not able to attend school because of a lack in funding. Donations that were promised, that were pledged, have not made it to them in order to be able to take care of these children and send them to school. They run an orphanage. The name of the orphanage, again, is Love Haiti's Children Orphanage. Now, you can actually go on their website at lovehaitischildren.com. Again, that's love, L-O-V-E, Haiti's, H-A-I-T-I-S, children, C-H-I-L-D-R-E-N.com. And you can go on their website and you can read about the orphanage. I printed off their vision of Love Haiti's Children, and I'm gonna just go ahead and just read you one paragraph. For many years, I had heard stories about Haiti, the poorest nation in the Western Hemisphere. I couldn't take the suspense any longer. In 2006, three others and I flew to Haiti. Although I have been doing overseas mission work for quite some time and have seen dire poverty, I was not prepared for what I witnessed in Haiti. I researched Haiti and was told what to expect, but that didn't matter. I was not prepared. It was hard for my mind to conceive that a country or a people could be that poor. In Haiti, there is poverty beyond words. A spirit of desperation and survival filled the air. Every place you looked, people were selling merchandise, cooking with charcoal on the sidewalks, and selling food to make money. The streets and roads are in terrible condition, the buildings are run down, and there's no clean water, and there's no sanitation system. Every place you looked, there were huge piles of rotted garbage in the streets of Port-au-Prince, with naked children, pigs and goats together searching through it for food. People were lying on the ground, sleeping as animals roamed around them. And it gets deeper. It's written by Bishop Jim McIver. But what I wanted to say in regards to this is, these children, they're lucky to even have this orphanage there trying to help them out. And we as black people have to be able to do better to take care of our own and stop waiting for white people to give us a handout. This video is not asking for donations from white people and other races. This video is asking our own people to stand up, walk up to the plate, and take care of what needs to be taken care of, to take care of our own people. You know, some of you may say, oh, well, we got children like that right here in the States. And I'd say, you know what, you're right. But then I turn around and ask you, what are you doing for them? And your answer is going to be, 9 times out of 10, you never thought of it. So here I am telling you right now, you have brothers and sisters in a worse condition than you are. You think life is bad for you? You think it's hard for you? Look at these kids. Look at these kids and what they have to go through. Look at their life. Look at the choices that are left before them. They don't have the same opportunities. They're not blessed with the same opportunities that you are. Now, instead of being selfish and always receiving and receiving and being a glutton, how about you send some of those blessings out and take care of your people? Because we don't need the white man to help us stand. We're supposed to have each other. There's no such thing as Haitian, Jamaican, Bahamian, and everybody separate, and nobody brothers and sisters, because guess what? We're all black. So we take care of all of our own around the world. That's how it should be. That's how we'd like it to be. That's how a black nation could rise up, when a black nation is able to take care of their own black people and not have to rely on other races for handouts, for charity. Maybe then we can get some respect. But for those that like to say Black Lives Matter, I have 12 kids right here. 12 black lives right here. That should matter as well. That should matter as well to all of us. Whether it's Black Lives Matter or All Lives Matter, these are still lives. These are lives. It's still lives. And they should matter to everyone. We're not going to mourn someone's passing. We're not going to cry about someone being dead and be like, oh, we wish we could have done something. Like the Syrian baby, like the dead baby in Syria that they want to keep showing you. Y'all feel bad. Oh, we need to do something. There's too many deaths. How about we prevent these deaths? These are alive right now. These are alive right now. How about we keep them from dying? Go to lovehaitischildren.com. You can download the sponsorship form. Like so. And then you have the option of being a monthly sponsor of $30 or more monthly, or you can do a one time, I'd like to give a special gift to help the children. But you can download this form, mail it, email it, fax it back to the contact information, and they'll go ahead and get you set up, and you could be doing your part to helping your people stand back up, united as a nation, taking care of our own, looking out for our own people. You have a problem with that? You're watching the wrong video. I'm NH Live doing this, signing off for TLE TV.
We used to dine as a people. The need for you to cry out loud so they can see you. But they don't want you equal, but they doing more to feed you just to keep you in line with the ghetto ideal procedure. But still we moving on, going strong. We done lived through the thick and now it's time to go on home. But ain't no home is what they telling me. We kicked the lawyer off shook with this tragedy, apparently. And mama's just a lady when she loses a baby. So with all the lives lost, what is left for our Haiti? H is for the honor that is missing. A is for the IUCN that still carry a vision. I is for the independence. The bloodshed in the streets is the perfect witness. And the T is for the time that we got left to reminisce. I is for the eye of God through all of this.
Every time I try to keep these images out of my head, something there that remind me of you. Every time I try to keep these nightmares out of my bed, over and over like I can't stop thinking about you.
Wonder why, cause I still got my flag and I wave it high. And when I pray, cause together they get terrified. So we're taught to steal and kill, Eurocentric Yankee lies. Alright, they'll never show you Haiti's beauty. Better show you all the hoods and the dumbzos in the movies. Not hating on the actors, go ahead and get your money. But your people looking on like, homie, what you doing?
Nigga, what are you doing?
Gotta rock my Haitian flag, rock these Haitian tags. Red and blue, do rare for my Haitian dad. And Haitian flag, they on the way, you see the pride in my face, cause we celebrate it every single day. Haitian flag, got that D, you go there, and that bun.